God, and that you have turned their hearts back. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, the wood, the stones, and the dust, and even licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and said, "The Lord indeed is God. The Lord indeed is God."
Would the children like to join me for the children's message this morning? Join me and a couple of friends I brought. I brought my friends this morning because I thought there might just be a few of us sitting up here. And so this gives five of us for the children's moment today. Let me see if I get my hand. Oh my goodness, 6, 7. We are blessed. Are we all set? Do my guys look pretty good? Trying to do two is kind of hard. But anyway, these are two friends of mine. This is my first puppet I got, and his name is Pickles. And this is the second puppet I got, and I named him Buddy. Good morning. Now, Pickles was named by a child. Actually, I think Pickles was, that little child was maybe in first grade. Yeah, first grader. And then I named Buddy, and I was like probably 50 years old when I named Buddy. Yeah. And so they come with me today, not only to have, so we have more children up here at the front of the for the children's message, but we're going to talk about a big word this morning, testimony. Have any of you ever heard about a testimony? It's kind of a big word, is it? Do they teach you about that in school? No. Testify, testify, testify. Okay, now sometimes when somebody goes into a courtroom, they testify, and they tell their story. And then there's a judge there that makes a ruling about them. But for us, when we testify, we can tell a story about anything. But this morning I want to think about if we would just tell a story about what we know about Jesus. If you were at school, okay, where they don't really talk about this much, but if you were at school, or let's say if you're home playing with some of your stuffed animals or some of your toys, and you're with your friend, and they ask you about Jesus, what would you say to them? Okay, you've got an answer. What would you say? Yeah, so he died on the cross. Okay, Buddy's going to have a question for you. Why did Jesus die on the cross for us? Right, so that we could have our sins forgiven and we could still go to heaven. Well, thank you very much. You know what? Thank you. That helps me understand more about Jesus. I appreciate that very much. Okay, does anybody else have anything that they know about God or Jesus or the Holy Spirit that you want to think about that you would want to maybe tell Pickles? Anybody want to tell me anything? Something maybe you learned in Sunday school? Maybe in blast? Or what about if some of you did some singing? Anybody sing in the musical? Raise your hand if you sang in the musical. All right. What did you learn about God in the musical? What's one thing that you learned about God in the music that you could tell me, Pickles? That's right. He loves everybody and forgives everybody's sins. Do you think he would love me? Yeah, I think, oh, good. That's good news, isn't it? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. So let us thank God for ways that God shows us how much he loves us and about Jesus and how he has helped us and that someday we'll all be in heaven. Shall we pray? Okay. My friends are going to pray with us too. They're ready to pray. Okay. Dear God, We thank you for the way that you love us and that Jesus died for us so that he could rise again and so that we would have hope to go to heaven, to be with him. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you all for coming up. Our second reading this morning comes from Luke chapter 7, verses 1 through 10. And the title of this in the Bible is called, Jesus Heals a Centurion's Servant. After Jesus had finished all his sayings in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum. A centurion there had a slave who he valued highly, and who was ill and close to death. When he heard about Jesus, he sent some Jewish elders to him, asking him to come and to heal his slave. When they came to Jesus, they appealed to him earnestly, saying, "He is worthy of having you do this for him, for he loves our people, and it is he who built our synagogue for us." And Jesus went with them. But he was not far from the house. The centurion sent friends to say to him, "Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy to have you come under my roof. Therefore, I did not presume to come to you, but only speak the word, and let my servant be healed. For I am also a man set under authority, with soldiers under me, and I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes, and to my slave, 'Do this,' and the slave does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed at him, and turning to the crowd that followed him, he said, "I tell you, not even in Israel have I found such faith. When those who had been sent returned to the house, they found the slave in good health." What is your faith testimony? This is a question that is not typically asked these days. It is not that we don't care about hearing the faith testimony of our friends. We may not ask this question because we think it is too personal. I agree. Your and my faith testimonies are personal. Our faith testimonies are a personal account of our relationship with God. One way we can share our faith testimony is to share what is on our hearts and our minds about God. A faith testimony doesn't have to be done in a specific format. Our faith testimony can be simply be about what we believe in, about God. Many years before I became a pastor, my friend Catherine and I shared our faith testimonies with each other. We were in her kitchen, looking into her backyard as our children played. She and her family were going through a very difficult time. And after she and I talked for a while, I said to her, "What would you think about asking Jesus to help you?" She thought for a moment and said, "I could do that." I asked her to come to church with me. During our time of prayer, I went forward to pray for her. My prayer that day was a silent prayer, because I was not sure in detail what to pray for, but I trusted that God would answer Catherine's prayer. Within a few weeks, Catherine's answers began to come. Her family was able to work through their problems. They were able to move forward with what was best for their family at that time. Catherine gave me permission to share her faith testimony many years ago. I guess in some ways it is also my faith testimony. It definitely is Catherine's faith testimony because she thought that God had helped her in her great time of need. It is also my faith testimony as I was able to witness what God was doing in the life of my friend and her family. You may be able to remember a similar experience with a friend. You and your friend are talking. In your conversation, your friend expresses a need. A need that as the two of you talk, you find that neither of you has the answer. As you seek God, you discover possible solutions become evident. As you and your friends seek these solutions, you can begin to know that God is really guiding you. The songs that we sing as a church can be a faith testimony to God. Think about poetry and music as a form of a faith testimony. Have you ever sung a song of praise that has touched your heart and mind and brought you closer to God and others? As we join our voices together, we have an opportunity to share our faith testimony through song. Even when you and I may not know all the words to a song, I remember when I first came here, they would be singing songs that I'd never heard before. And so I would just listen to the tune and the music, and eventually as I kept coming to church, I began to learn those songs. There is something meaningful about hearing the voices of others as well and blending our voices together with the beautiful instruments that we have, with the praise band, with the organ, and feeling that unity of being together in worship. That is a testimony for us personally and for us together as a church. Elijah's testimony from 1 Kings 18 verses 30 to 39 includes prayer, worship, and thanksgiving. His faith testimony is about demonstrating the presence of God to the people in his faith tradition. During the time in which Elijah lived, there seemed to be a battle between the God of Israel and other gods that people followed. In the section of the scripture this morning, Elijah has been able to conduct worship in the setting of a holy mountain. He has prepared worship according to his Jewish faith tradition. He understands the guidelines for his preparation have come from God. Included in the worship setting are representations of nature, the animals that are sacrificed, fire to prepare the offering, and grain from the fields, and water that is poured upon all encircles the fire. Upon praying for God to provide fire for the sacrifice, Elijah is able to testify to the presence of God. Elijah's faith increases along with the faith of others in the God of Israel, just through worship. Jesus shares a faith testimony in the story of the healing of a servant of the Roman centurion. Jesus has finished teaching to many people. He leaves that setting and enters into a community where people have heard about him and witnessed the many miracles that have occurred in his presence. The testimony that Jesus shares is about the faith of a Roman centurion, a Roman soldier. The Roman centurion has requested help from Jesus for one of his servants who needs healing. However, he has not spoken to Jesus directly. Instead, the Roman centurion has contacted other Jewish leaders to make the request for healing for him. Jesus testifies to the Roman centurion's faith as being more than Jesus is found in those who already believe in God. It is through the faith of the Roman centurion that his servant is healed. I am hopeful that these examples provide possible images for you and me as we consider our own faith testimonies this morning. Some of you may have been reminded of a friend's faith testimony. I encourage you to remember that faith testimony today. Do you know that listening to the faith testimony of another is as important as sharing your own faith testimony? When you and I listen to each other's faith testimonies, it provides an opportunity for the one who is sharing their faith testimony to hear how it sounds. When you and I listen to each other's faith testimonies,